Good morning, students. I hope you all are doing well. Today, we are going to do chapter 2, Fritz, of our Echo's book. Before doing the chapter, I want to mention a very important point. Children, read the text again so that you can quote important keywords and lines from the text. This video will cover the following objectives. We will try to understand the story, to build critical thinking, to create an overall understanding of and appreciation for literature and individual who produced the masterwork, to build reading skills. The story Fritz has been written by Satyajit Ray. He was an Indian filmmaker who was born in Calcutta on May 2, 1921 and died on April 23, 1992. As a filmmaker, he is known for his humanistic approach to cinema. He is best known as a reputed international level filmmaker and director, though he tried his hand successfully in other fields such as writing, music, graphic design, advertisement, calligraphy, etc. He is regarded as one of our best filmmakers. He won 32 Indian National Film Awards, a number of international awards including the prestigious Oscar for Lifetime Achievement in 1992. He was also honored with the Bharat Ratna in 1992. He wrote several short stories and novels, both for children and adults. His most famous characters are Feluda, the sleuth, and Professor Shonku, the scientist. He was awarded an honorary degree by Oxford University. Let us start with the plot development of the story. Fritz is one of Ray's horror stories in which a man named Jayanto, the protagonist, underline the word, write down main character, of the story had returned to Bundi in Rajasthan after 31 years. Bundi is a small town in Rajasthan, and after 31 years, our main character, he returned to Bundi. He was accompanied by his friend Shankar, who had been his friend from school days. So Jayanto and Shankar, they visited a place called Bundi. They were staying in a circuit house when they went for a stroll. Underline the word stroll, it means walk. In the garden, Jayanto's childhood memories of place came back. So in Bundi, they were living in a circuit house. And when they were having a walk in that garden, in the garden of the circuit house, Jayanto, as he was living there, and after 31 years, he had come back to that place. So he was memorizing his childhood memories. Jayanto recalled how his doll called Fritz was destroyed by two stray dogs and he buried it under the deodar tree in the garden of the circuit house. So we have come to another location in the circuit house, that is deodar tree. Earlier they were strolling in garden and now he is remembering about the doll which he buried under the deodar tree. And where was that deodar tree? In the garden of the circuit house. At night, Jayanto was woken up by a feeling that something had walked over his chest when he was sleeping. Jayanto, along with Shankar, was sleeping in a room when he had an illusion that something had walked over his chest. Jayanto showed Shankar tiny brown circular marks on the cover of his quilt. So the illusion which Jayanto had that something had walked over his chest was reality, as he had tiny brown circular marks on the cover of his quilt. Jayanto told Shankar the next day that it was Fritz. Now what is Fritz? Fritz is the doll who visited their room the previous night. Shankar suggested to Jayanto to dig the ground where he had buried Fritz. On digging the earth, to their utter surprise, they found a skeleton of a human being resembling the size of Fritz. Thus, the author has left the story open-ended for readers to decide whether Fritz was a ghost or a supernatural being, or it was just Jayanto's childhood imagination. Hope that you have been clear about the summary of the story. Now let us talk about the setting of the story. The entire story takes place in Bundi, a small town in Rajasthan. So children, remember, the entire plot of the story is set in a place named Bundi. It is in Rajasthan. The action in the story begins in a circuit house in Bundi, which Jayanto, the protagonist, I told you earlier, protagonist means the main character of the story, had visited as a child with his parents. So Jayanto had visited the place circuit house in Bundi when he was a child. Now after 31 years, he is coming back to that place. The time Jayanto was accompanied by his childhood friend Shankar, during their stay in the circuit house, Jayanto could slowly and in bits and pieces recall his previous visit. So Jayanto was accompanied by his friend Shankar and he was not able to memorize everything very quickly. It was taking time, but yes, he was able to memorize his earlier visit to the place Bundi with his parents. The first thing he could recall was a deodar tree, but could not exactly say what was the association. So at Bundi, he lived in a circuit house, and in circuit house, there was a garden in which there was a deodar tree. On seeing that deodar tree, he could remember something, but he was not able to connect. As meaning of word association is connect. He was not able to connect that what was connected with deodar tree. He could find the same tree in far end of the compound in the circuit house. So where was this deodar tree? It was in the far end of the compound in the circuit house. Gradually, he was able to describe his connection with the tree. Slowly, he was memorizing. As he was memorizing everything, he was able to connect with the memory related to the deodar tree. He was reminded of a Swiss doll that his uncle had gifted him and which he had buried under the deodar tree after two stray dogs had torn it apart. So now he was able to connect that what was the association with that deodar tree. Once his uncle had gifted him a Swiss doll. That Swiss doll was torn apart by two stray dogs and he had buried it under the deodar tree. It was under this tree that after getting the earth dug, they found a 12-inch long skeleton of a human being. So when he remembered about the doll which he had buried under that deodar tree, he had some illusion. So in order to clear that illusion, they decided to dig the ground, and when they dug that ground, they found the skeleton of a human being. Now what was very weird about that skeleton? It was of the same size as Fritz was. This is the weirdness of that skeleton. It was of the size of the Fritz. The only other place mentioned in the story is the Bundi Fort, which Jayanto and his friend Shankar visited. So the another place mentioned there is Bundi Fort. But Jayanto showed no interest in the fort and insisted upon Shankar to return to the circuit house. As Jayanto was in a perplexed and confused state of mind, he did not want to go to Bundi Fort. He wanted to go back to the circuit house because he remembered about Fritz. Now the memories of Fritz was disturbing him. Thus, in keeping the supernatural, underline the word supernatural, some force beyond scientific understanding. I have done with you earlier the word paranormal. Paranormal and supernatural means the same. The supernatural element in the story, it is aptly set in an atmosphere necessary to create a feeling of creepiness. Underline the word creepiness. It means the state of causing fear or unease. So Jayanto, he was feeling very creepy. He was feeling very uneasy. He was in fear on remembering about Fritz. That builds up steadily. Steadily means constantly throughout the story. So the author has beautifully used suspense, his ghostly element, his supernatural element in the story, Fritz. So students, in this video, I have discussed about the author, key points of the story. Your homework is to revise the same and read summary on page 21 and 22 of your workbook. And very importantly, read it again so that you can quote important lines and keywords. कीप रीडिंग.